about your life so far. I said, not a single solitary thing. I think every my footsteps were ordained. I was supposed to be, was supposed to be in Atlanta in 93. And I was supposed to be at Dark. And I was supposed to be at Red Zone Entertainment with Tricky.
Yes.
And I was supposed to be writing.
Yes.
And, you know, I might not have moved here to do that, but it eventually got to that. So I'm happy.
All right. What a heck of an intro. All right, guys, we're going to see y'all. I'm only kidding. They're like, wait a second. Kwanzaa, this question is for you, Johnny and Dave. I want you guys to answer this because you said a key word. You said community, right? So we're in the information of technology and learning. So when you look at the two generations, right, how do we continue to keep the information flowing between generations when you have a generation of, as Dave said earlier, the mumble rappers and those that still need to learn the history and the generation that's before us that's trying to just simply keep up with the times?
Ooh, that's a good one. I think we have to almost double down on our desire to be connected to one another. Someone said it earlier, we're all on cell phones, and that removes half of our ability to connect as human beings. If you're in the studio and you're writing and you're in a creative space, you do connect. But once you walk outside of there, you don't. And we find the same thing even as elected officials. The old guard doesn't quite understand where we're coming from. They all talk to each other, but they don't talk to us. And so we gotta like break down the barriers and just try to get to know each other. But I do think a lot of the responsibility does fall on those who are older because we've kind of been there. So we have to, again, make ourselves available. You know, if you're willing and